Yeah, no, I mean, it doesn't get much closer than that. I mean, it could have gone either way, but you know, I think he outplayed me a bit today from the baseline, and he was returning much better than me, and I think that made the big difference in the match. But he's playing very well, and hopefully he can go in the finals and do well also.
To me, you seemed a little flat compared with previous matches. I mean, maybe it just wasn't quite there for you. I mean, is that down to it maybe just being a match too far? I mean, you've played a lot of tennis recently.
Yeah, I mean, I've played a lot of tennis, but like I said, my ground strokes weren't feeling very good today. But, you know, I was serving fine. I was volleying pretty well, and I did my best out there, but it wasn't enough. And you know, he played very well, and also he's putting a lot of pressure on my ground strokes, and that wasn't helping me out much. But you know, I was tough. I tried a few different things. It just wasn't working out.
The other thing I thought was, obviously everyone thinks of you getting to the net, putting the volleys away. You did that more as the match went on, but early on, maybe not being able to get to net quite as much as you would have liked.
Yeah, not quite as much as I would like at all. But you know, also he passes very well. He likes to see me come in, which he does. He passes me in practice all the time, and he loves it. But you know, I knew it was gonna be a tough matchup going into it, and I had my chances here and there, but just came up a little bit short.
Obviously, it's disappointing, but I mean, a terrific recent run for you. Let's look back on that briefly. I mean, winning Roehampton, winning the Grade One, getting through to the semis here. I mean, it's still been a really good results for you.
Yeah, no, it's been very good past couple of weeks, and you know, I'm happy with my results. And obviously, I wish I could have won today, but you know, it happens, and it'll be all right.
I know this is a little bit of a moot point about the whole sports management thing, about leaks and everything. I don't want to talk directly about that because I know that is a bit of a problem area. Maybe people have said things they shouldn't have or whatever, released things. In terms of on-court plans for you for the next few months, I mean, what are you looking to do in terms of juniors? What are your plans tournament-wise? I guess we can talk about that, what you're looking to do with your tennis for the next few months.
I'm going to Croatia next week. I'm the practice partner for the Davis Cup there. So I get to hit with like James Blake and Andy Roddick and those guys, and Brian Brothers, and so that'll be fun to be there during that. And after that, I think I'm heading to Indianapolis maybe for qualies there, and maybe some challengers and some tournament stuff leading up to the U.S. Open. I think this was my last junior tournament, I think, so you know, not. I'm hoping for the U.S. Open main draw wild card, which you get usually if you win the NCAA tournament, and so keeping my fingers crossed for that one, and hopefully just play some tournaments leading up to that and try and get ready for it.
Just a final word on the match on court four today. I saw a lot of famous names watching you and Jordan playing. I mean, just your thoughts on that, because I saw Billie Jean King in the crowd. Todd Martin was there as well. A lot of famous names from American tennis. How do you feel about that?
Oh yeah, it's pretty exciting to have those guys watching in the crowd. But you know, it was a great match, and I'm sure they were entertained with the score at least. And it was. You know, it was a lot of fun to see the crowd and everything. But you know, it's been very exciting playing here.